CYW USB 6935 Wireless USB LR 2.4 GHz DSSS Radio SoC Cypress Semiconductor. Welcome to this training module on Cypress's CYW USB 6935 Wireless LR 2.4 GHz DSSS Radio SoC. This training module introduces the wireless USB technology and the CYW USB 693 Wireless USB Transceiver. Wireless technologies have gained rapid acceptance in the marketplace, and the growth continues to accelerate. The ability to move data without having to connect a cable, run wires, or worry about having the right adapters is very appealing. Wireless offers the promise of convenience, speed, and ease of use. Wireless is still all about moving information from point A to B. Depending upon the needs of the application, data may move more quickly in one direction or the other, or it might need to move in both directions. There are many different wireless technologies in use or emerging today. Examples include Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, Zigbee, ultra-wideband, and many more. These technologies differ in many ways, such as frequency spectrum, data rates, data encoding, protocols, network topologies, and others. The Cypress Wireless USB and the PROC products are aimed at mid to low data rates, up to 1 megabit per second, and simple cable replacements or simple network topologies. Wireless USB only supports moving data in one direction at a time. Thus, it is half duplex. Here gives the differences between wireless USB and 27 MHz technology. And here introduces the differences between wireless USB and Bluetooth technologies. The CYW USB 6935 provides a complete spy-to-antenna radio modem. The CYW USB 6935 is designed to implement wireless device operating in a worldwide 2.4 GHz industrial, scientific, and medical frequency band of 2.4 GHz to 2.4835 GHz. The CYW USB 6935 contains a 2.4 GHz radio transceiver, a GFSK modem, and a dual DSSS configurable baseband. The radio and baseband are both code and frequency agile. 49 spreading codes are selected for optimum performance. Those are gold codes and are supported across 78 1 MHz channels, yielding a theoretical spectrum capacity of 3,822 channels. The CYW USB 6935 supports a range of up to 50 meters or more. Here shows overall areas where the device can be used. This device will fit into more or less every area where we require wireless connectivity with suitable data rates. It can go into home, building automation, industrial control, meter reading, consumer applications like remote, toys, locator, alarms, presenter tools, etc. The CYW USB 6935 transceiver is a single chip 2.4 GHz direct sequence spread spectrum Gaussian frequency shift keying baseband radio modem that connects directly to a microcontroller via a simple serial peripheral interface. As stated previously, the CYW USB 6935 contains a 2.4 GHz radio transceiver, a GFSK modem, and a dual DS-SS reconfigurable baseband. The radio and baseband are both code and frequency agile. 49 spreading codes selected for optimal performance are supported across 78 1 MHz channels, yielding a theoretical capacity of 3,822 channels. The CYW USB 6935 supports a range of up to 50 meters. This transmitter uses a DSP-based vector modulator to generate an accurate GFSK carrier. The receiver uses a fully integrated frequency modulator detector with automatic data slicer to demodulate the GFSK signal. Data is converted to the DSSS chips by a digital spreader. Despreading is performed using an oversampling correlator. The DSSS baseband cancels spurious noise and assembles properly correlated data bytes. The DSSS baseband has three operating modes: 64 chips per bit, single channel, 32 chips per bit, single channel, and 32 chips per bit, single channel, dual data rate. The CYW USB 6935 provides a data serializer-deserializer, a SerDes, which provides byte-level framing of transmit and receive data. Bytes for transmission are loaded into the SerDes, and receive bytes are read from the SerDes via the SPI interface. The SerDes provides double buffering of transmit and receive data. While one byte is being transmitted by the radio, the next byte can be written to the SerDes data register, ensuring there are no breaks in transmitted data. The CYW USB 6935 has a fully synchronous SPI slave interface for connectivity to the application microcontroller. Configuration and byte-oriented data transfer can be performed over this interface. An interrupt is provided to trigger real-time events. Wireless USB LS utilizes a 2.4 GHz direct sequence spread spectrum DSSS radio interface. DSSS generates a redundant bit pattern for each bit to be transmitted. This bit pattern is called a chip, or pseudo-noise code. Because they use direct sequence spread spectrum technology, wireless USB systems encode their data within pseudo-noise, or PN, codes. The main advantage is to increase the robustness and recoverability of the signal in the presence of interference. A simple explanation is that a single data bit from the application is represented by multiple bits when sent across the air and decoded back into the original data bit on the other side. One result of using PN codes is that devices in a given network must agree to use a common PN code in order to understand one another. Another advantage of this is that it increases the co-location capabilities, since devices can share the same channel if they use different PN codes. The pseudo-noise code is a binary signal that is produced at a much higher frequency than the data is transmitted. Because it has a higher frequency, it has a large bandwidth that spreads the signal in the frequency domain. The nature of this signal makes it appear that it is random noise. The wide bandwidth provided by the pseudo-noise code allows the signal power to drop below the noise threshold without losing any information. This allows DSSS signals to operate in noisy environments and reduces the interference caused by traditional narrowband signals. In the presence of interference, the transmitted PN code will often be received with some PN code chips corrupted. The receiver uses the data correlator to decode the incoming data stream. If the number of chip errors is less than the correlator error threshold, the data will be correctly received. Otherwise, the data bit will be marked as unknown, and the software error recovery mechanism will be used to recover the unknown bit. In the wireless USB protocol, PIN code is a 1-byte number index to the gold code table. Changing the receiver's PIN code is equivalent to changing the 32-chip or 64-chip pattern that the receiver is trying to look for. The RSSI register, register hex 22, returns the relative signal strength of the on-channel signal power and can be used to determine the connection quality, determine the value of the noise floor, and check for a quiet channel before transmitting. The internal RSSI voltage is sampled through a 5-bit analog-to-digital converter. The conversion produces a 5-bit value in the RSSI register along with a valid bit. Once a connection has been established, the RSSI register can be read to determine the relative connection quality of the channel. To check for a quiet channel before transmitting, first set up the receiver mode properly and read the RSSI register. Then, wait for 50 microseconds and read the RSSI register again. Next, clear the carrier detect register and turn the receiver off. A RSSI register value of 0 to 10 indicates a channel that is relatively quiet. An RSSI register value greater than 10 indicates the channel is probably being used. An RSSI register value greater than 28 indicates the presence of a strong signal. The ISM band is a busy spectrum with a lot of different technologies sharing the band. Therefore, managing interference is an important consideration. The DSSS technology itself is the first stage of managing interference. In the presence of a stronger interference, the DSS technology by itself may be enough to overcome the interference. There are other mechanisms for overcoming interference. The first is detecting the interference, which can be accomplished by monitoring the background noise level using the measurement of signal strength. Once interference has been detected, the system must then identify a channel with an acceptable level of interference and then move all nodes on the system to this new channel. This slide shows a block diagram example of a typical battery-powered device using the CYW USB 6939 chip. The CYW USB 6935 uses a 4-wire SPI to communicate with the application microcontroller. This diagram shows a microcomputer interface with this wireless USB device and its sequence. The 4-wire SPI communications interface consists of a master out slave in, master in slave out, serial clock, and slave select lines. The SPI receives S-clock from an application microcomputer on the S-clock pin. Data from the application microcomputer is shifted in on the master out slave in pin. Data to the application microcomputer is shifted out on the master in slave out pin. The active low slave state pin must be asserted to initiate a SPI transfer. This figure shows the application schematic using this device as a network-connected device, one master and many slaves.